Okay, so now let's go back to Microsoft Excel and try to see how we can solve the same problem, 2 minus x plus ln x equal to 0, this time using essentially not the bisection method but the reguli falsi method. As we had seen a few moments back, the difference between bisection method and reguli falsi method is only in the way x of I plus 1 is computed, remaining everything remains the same. So because of that, I'll for just to save some time, what I will do is I will just copy this particular worksheet by clicking on move and copy. I will just create a copy of this worksheet before sheet 2. Okay, so now what we have is a copy of the worksheet in which we use the bisection method. I will call this reguli falsi. Okay, and in reguli falsi again we are interested in solving the problem 2 minus x plus ln of x equal to 0, this time using reguli falsi method. Okay, so what I will do is really all these values I will just delete them. Okay, and then okay, so now we have our original worksheet, the first row of the worksheet that we had used for the bisection method, and that is what we will use essentially for our reguli falsi method. So our XL, again the same way as before, we start with XL equal to 1, XR equal to 4. We compute our f of x of L in the same manner as before, we compute our f of x of R in the same manner as before. Now what changes is how xi plus 1 is computed, and the way, so what I have done is just deleted this x of I plus 1, and because this x of I plus 1 does not have any value in it over here, that is why we are getting an error when Excel computes its solutions. Okay, so x of I plus 1, if you recall, was equal to x of L minus, okay, we had x of L minus f of L multiplied by xl minus xr multiplied by xl minus xr divided by fl minus fr. Okay, this is our x of I plus 1. Okay, so again what we have done is I will just write down the equation x for x of I plus 1. X of I plus 1 is nothing but xl minus f of l multiplied by x of l minus x of r divided by in brackets f of l minus f of r. Okay, this is what our and just to make it easy to read, I will just make it into Times New Roman. Okay, so in now let's look at the function that we get over here, f x of I plus 1. So what we need, x of I plus 1 is nothing but xl, which is the column B, row 4, that is B4. So xl is B4 minus f of l, which is D4, multiplied by B4 minus C4, right, B4 minus C4, which is x of l minus x of r, divided by f of l minus f of r. F of l is in basically D4 and f of r is in E4. So what we have is B4 representing x of l minus D4 representing f of l, multiplied by B4 minus C4, which represents the difference x of l minus x of r, divided by D4 minus E4, which represents the difference f of l minus f of r. Okay, this is what we have over here. once we get x of I plus 1, we will compute f of x of I plus 1 in the same manner. Again, we have not changed it from what we had done in the bisection method. Remember, when I was showing it on the board, all we did was we replaced the way in the second part, the second step, in that is the way we compute x of I plus 1 given given xl and xr. That is the only thing that changes. So, f of I plus 1 is nothing but 2 minus x of I plus 1 plus ln of x of I plus 1. Okay. We get the product f of l multiplied by f of I plus 1. Because this particular product is positive, that means essentially x of I plus 1 lies on the same side of as x of l, and we replace x of l with x of I plus 1. Okay. So, what we are now going to do essentially is really just take these guys and just drag them below, and this is going to be our new x of I plus 1. Okay. And likewise, we will have a new value for error as well. Okay. So, this is the result at iteration 2, and if we want to get the results at iteration 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so on and so forth, we just highlight the entire row, go to the right bottom edge of that row and just drag it downwards, and let us drag it until say 10 iterations. Okay. So, this is what happens in 10 iterations using the regular FOLC method. We started with 1, 4. The next value of x of I plus 1 is 2.8859 and so on and so forth. And as you can see, our stopping criterion was that the error should fall below 10 to the power minus 4. So, this is the point where the error has fallen below 10 to the power minus 4, and this is going to be the solution that we get. And again, we will highlight this solution. And we really don't need any of this data; that's redundant data. So when we are using the regular FOLC method, now what we actually have is basically in about 5 iterations, we have gone from the initial solution of 1, 4, and we have finally reached the actual solution 3.14615. Okay. That particular solution is accurate within the desired accuracy that we had selected, that is 10 to the power minus 4. Okay. So now what we will do is just take a few minutes before finishing off this lecture, take a few minutes to just recap what we have done in this particular lecture. So what we have done in this lecture is, initially we gave an overview of what we mean by nonlinear equation solving. Nonlinear equation solving is nothing but finding out the points at which any curve f of x intersects the x axis. That is the interpretation, the geometric interpretation, when we look at this problem in a one dimensional sense. So, that is the geometric interpretation of solving the nonlinear equations. We then talked about the various methods of solving the nonlinear equations. The methods came in 2 categories. The first category was bracketing method, in which we start with 2 solutions, and the 2 solutions are going to bracket our actual solution x star. At each point of time, we will ensure that the 2 guesses are going to lie on either side of our true solution x star. That is what we did in both the regular FOLC method as well as the bisection method. The way bisection method worked is, we take an initial segment, for example, in the example that we took, we said took the segment between x of l equal to 1 and x of r equal to 4, and at each iteration we half the overall length of segment. So, the length of segment from 3 it went to 1.5, from 1.5 it went to 0.75, 1.75 it went to 0.375, and so on and so forth, and we slowly converge on to the true solution x star. That is what we did in the bisection method. Then we covered the regular FOLC method. In the regular FOLC method, the overall procedure was the same, except the way we found the solution x of I plus 1, the next guess of the solution x of I plus 1. And the way we did that is, we joined the point xl fl and the point xl xr fr, we joined it with a straight line and found the point where that straight line intersects the x axis, that became our new guess. So that is how we covered the two bracketing methods, bisection method and the regular falsi method. In the next lecture, we are going to cover the open methods, specifically the fixed point iteration, the Newton-Raphson's method and the secant method. Okay. Thank you and see you in the next lecture.